Hello everyone, welcome to lecture series on basic electronics. We have started with module number 2, that is FET and SER. Contents covered in the previous lecture are introduction to field effect transistors. Later we have discussed types of FETs. There are two types of FETs, one is JFET and another one is MOSFET. So we have given a brief introduction for in JFET. So again in JFET there are two types, one is N-channel JFET and P-channel JFET. So N-channel JFET construction and its working along with the drain characteristics was discussed in the previous lecture. So contents that is covered in this lecture are MOSFET, types of MOSFET, working of DE MOSFET. Learning outcomes. After this lecture, the students will have a better understanding of MOSFETs, construction and working of N-channel DE MOSFET. So we know that FETs are classified into two main types, that is JFET and MOSFET. So MOSFET stands for metal oxide field effect transistor. It is a device in which the variation in the voltage determines the conductivity of the device. That is nothing but any gate voltage we are going to apply, it is going to make a variation in the drain current. So that is, drain current is controlled by the applied gate voltage. MOSFETs are sometimes called as an IGFET. IGFET stands for insulated gate field effect transistor. It is called as MOSFET because a semiconductor channel and a gate, it is separated by a very thin oxide layer. So hence it is called as an insulated gate field effect transistor. MOSFETs are three terminal devices. The three terminals are gate, drain, source, and along with these three terminals we have a substrate. So here MOSFETs are in case of MOSFET, the drain current is completely controlled by the applied gate voltage. The classification of MOSFET. So MOSFETs are mainly classified into two types. One is enhancement mode MOSFET and another one is depletion mode MOSFET. So in enhancement mode we have P-channel enhancement mode MOSFET and N-channel enhancement mode MOSFET. So similarly, in case of depletion mode, we have P-channel depletion mode MOSFET as well as N-channel depletion mode MOSFET. So this is the classification of MOSFET. So we know that MOSFET basically they are available in two forms. So one is called as an DE MOSFET. So that is nothing but depletion enhancement MOSFET. In short, we will call it as an DE MOSFET. So this DE MOSFET can be operated both in depletion mode and enhancement mode. So hence it is called as an depletion enhancement MOSFET or DE MOSFET. So in this mode, we have N-channel and P-channel DE MOSFETs are available. So similarly, there is one more type of MOSFET available called as an enhancement MOSFET. So in short, it is called as an E-MOSFET. Whereas in case of an E-MOSFET, MOSFET can be operated only in an enhancement mode. So hence it is called as an enhancement MOSFET. So again in E-MOSFET or enhancement MOSFET, we have N-channel and P-channel E-MOSFET. So MOSFET, it is classified into two types, depletion enhancement MOSFET. In short, it is called as an DE MOSFET, which is going to operate both in depletion mode and enhancement mode. Another type of MOSFET is enhancement MOSFET. It is called as an E MOSFET, which is going to operate only in an enhancement mode. So this is regarding classification of MOSFET. So now let us discuss depletion type MOSFET. So depletion type MOSFET, or in also called as an DE MOSFET. So in case of depletion announcement mode MOSFET, a channel is available, that is physically a channel is connected between drain and source terminal. So channel is readily available between drain and source terminal. So due to this, current flows between source to drain without any gate bias voltage. So without applying any gate bias voltage, already the channel is available. So therefore, no gate voltage is required to create the channel. So because without applying any gate bias voltage, there is a movement of electrons from, or there is a movement of charge carriers from source to drain. So but the purpose of gate voltage, it is used to control the flow of drain current. So gate voltage is the main parameter which is used to modulate the flow of current through the device by changing the channel width. So this depletion type MOSFET transistor, it is normally a closed switch, or even it is called as an depletion announcement MOSFET, it is called as an on device. So this depletion type MOSFET transistor requires gate source voltage. So in order to switch off the device, we are going to make use of gate source voltage, or by biasing the gate, we are going to control the flow of drain current. So let us discuss the symbols of N channel and P channel DE MOSFET. So this is a symbol for an N channel DE MOSFET. So wherein we have gate terminal, drain and source. So substrate and source together they are shorted and connected. This is an N channel DE MOSFET. Check out the arrow direction. So P channel DE MOSFET with the three terminals, gate, drain, source, along with that substrate is combined. So these are the symbols of N channel and P channel DE MOSFET. So let us discuss the construction of an DE MOSFET. So that is N channel DE MOSFET. So here, in case of an N channel DE MOSFET, or generally MOSFET, we know that it is a three terminal device, that is source, gate and drain. So here the type of the channel that is used is N channel, so hence we call it as an N channel DE MOSFET. So this N channel DE MOSFET, it is physically connected between drain and source terminal, that is, we have two N plus regions which are heavily doped, that are going to get linked by an N channel which are formed on the substrate, that is source and drain terminal are formed by connecting a metal contact for the two N plus regions. So we have source terminal and drain terminal, so we have a metal contact over here in order to make a connection. So gate terminal is connected to an insulating SiO2 layer on the top of the N channel, so therefore there is no direct electrical connection between gate terminal and the channel. So this is an SiO2 layer, so that is an oxide layer, there is a thin oxide layer that is present between the gate terminal and N channel. So because of this SiO2 layer presence, so there is no direct electrical connection between this gate terminal as well as the available channel of the DE MOSFET. So there is a capacitance that exists between gate and channel. So as the metal gate contact and the channel acts as a walls of a parallel plate capacitor of SiO2, forms the dielectric. Hence, the input impedance of DE MOSFET is very high. So this is the construction of an N-channel DE MOSFET. So we have a P-type substrate. So on a p-type substrate we have an n-channel that is going to connect the source and drain. The source and drain are connected by the two heavily doped 2n+ region. So in between we have the between gate and channel we have an oxide layer. So this is regarding construction of DE MOS FET, n channel DE MOS FET. So let us discuss working of depletion enhancement MOS FET. So we know that DE stands for depletion enhancement MOS FET. So this MOS FET works in both depletion mode as well as enhancement mode. So let us check out the different cases of the depletion enhancement MOS FET. Case 1, here VDS is positive and VGS is equal to 0. So let us understand this working of a DE MOS FET by considering a different voltages that are that can be applied between drain and source and between gate source voltage, that is voltage between gate and source. The first case says that VDS is positive. So VDS means DS indicates it is drain source. VDS means voltage between drain source. So here voltage between drain and source is positive. So this is the drain terminal and this is a source terminal. S stands for source, G stands for it is a gate terminal. So we have a positive VDS, that is positive terminal of the power supply is connected to the drain terminal, whereas negative of the power supply is connected to the source terminal, keeping VGS is equal to 0. So VGS is equal to 0 means that is gate source voltage applied is 0. No gate source voltage is applied. It is completely 0. So as here we have a positive terminal connected to the drain terminal, so here we have a positive potential. So because of this negative terminal which is connected to the source terminal, so this source terminal can be connected to an n+ region with the help of this metal contact. So because of this negative potential, the electrons that are present near the source terminal, they start to ripple and move towards the drain side. Because at the drain side we have a positive potential. So because of positive potential, electrons starts to ripple from source side and they are attracted towards the drain side. So thus we have a drain current. Therefore that is electrons are moving from source to drain and we have a drain current ID. So here further we can increase the value of VDS. So keep on increasing the value of VDS, so there will be an increase in the drain current. So further there is a drain current comes to a constant value. Further increasing in VDS does not increase the drain current, so it will reach to a saturation point. So therefore when VDS is equal to positive and VGS is equal to 0, then drain current become equal to IDSS, that is it is a saturation drain current. So further increase in VDS does not increase the value of the drain current, it comes to a saturation point. So further there will be no increase in the drain current. So this is the case when we apply a positive VDS and VGS is equal to 0. So second case is whenever a VDS is positive and VGS is equal to negative. So when a VDS is positive, as usual positive of the power supply is connected to the drain terminal and negative of the power supply is connected to the source terminal, and we have a gate source voltage as negative. So that is negative terminal of the power supply is connected to the gate, whereas positive potential it is connected to the source terminal. So now whenever a negative potential is connected to the negative terminal of the power supply is connected to the gate terminal, now because of this negative potential the electrons that are present in the n channel they starts to ripple. they starts to ripple, and the holes that are present in the p-type substrate, they are attracted towards the gate terminal. Anyhow, because of this SiO2 layer present, a thin oxide layer is present, they are not going to cross this SiO2 layer and get attracted by the gate terminal. So there means more number of positive or more number of holes are going to get attracted due to this negative potential which is available at the gate terminal, and they are not going to cross the SiO2 layer. So more number of holes are going to get accumulated in the n channel by reducing the number of electrons present in the n channel. So electrons are going to get repelled because of this negative potential available at the gate terminal. Therefore, it is going to reduce the number of electrons that are present in the n channel. And all the holes that are in the p substrate, they are going to get accumulated in the n channel. So this reduces the drain current. So keep on increasing the VGS. As we keep on increasing the negative gate source voltage, then more and more number of holes are going to get accumulated in the n channel by reducing the number of electrons in the n channel. So this makes drain current, this is going to reduce the drain current. So increase in VGS in a negative direction, it is going to decrease the drain current. So hence we call it as, whenever a VDS is equal to positive and VGS is equal to negative, then it is considered to be as a depletion MOSFET. So it works in the mode of depletion. So it is in the depletion mode MOSFET. So because more number of holes are going to accumulate in the n channel, by reducing the number of free electrons in the n channel, this reduces the drain current. Hence we call it as an depletion mode MOSFET. The third case is VDS is positive and VGS is positive. So VGS is positive means now gate source voltage is positive. So this becomes more positive compared to this terminal. So whenever a positive terminal is present, whenever a gate terminal is positive, then the number in case of p-type substrate, we know that majority carriers are holes and minority carriers are electrons. So the minority carriers, which are the electrons, they are going to get attracted towards the gate side. So more and more number of electrons are going to get accumulated in the n channel. So this is going to happen because of the positive gate voltage. So in case of positive gate voltage, so this becomes more positive, and here the terminal is plus. So because of this positive potential, all the electrons, they start to move towards the n channel. So electrons are going to move towards the n channel. So therefore we have more number of free electrons present. So increase in the VGS, it is going to increase the drain current. So hence it is called as an enhancement MOSFET. So it is going to enhance the drain current, it is going to increase the drain current. So therefore it is called as an enhancement MOSFET. So in case of VDS is equal to positive and VGS is equal to positive, we refer it as an enhancement MOSFET, increases the drain current. And in case of VGS is equal to negative, it is going to decrease the drain current, and we call it as an depletion mode MOSFET. So therefore DMOSFET can be operated in either of two modes. One we call it as an depletion mode and another one is enhancement mode. Either it will be operated in a depletion mode or it will be operated in an enhancement mode. So therefore sometimes we call it as an depletion enhancement MOSFET. The n channel MOSFET operates in depletion mode when a negative gate source voltage is applied. So remember, whenever we are working with n channel MOSFET, So it is going to get operated in a depletion mode when we apply a negative gate source voltage, and it is going to work in an enhancement mode when a positive gate source voltage is applied. So these devices are generally operated in a depletion mode. At a sufficiently negative gate source voltage, so if I keep on increasing the negative gate source voltage, so then completely the channel is going to get depleted and there is no drain current. So that condition we call it as an VGS off, or it is going to off the device completely. So there is no drain current. Drain current is completely zero. So suppose if we apply a positive voltage is applied between gate and source. So as I told, more number of free electrons are induced in the N channel, which is going to increase or enhance the channel conductivity. So thus we have ID. ID is going to get increased. So we have a depletion enhancement MOS FET drain characteristics. So this is the drain characteristics curve of DE MOS FET. So drain characteristics curve is the plot of VDS versus ID. VDS means it is drain source voltage versus drain current, that is ID. So for a given value of VGS. So when we apply gate source voltage is equal to zero. So whenever the first case says that no gate source voltage is equal to 0 volts. So when we keep gate source voltage is equal to 0 volts, so ID increases, so linearly. So at a certain point of time, the current remains constant for the increase in VDS. So further, there is no increase in the drain current. So ID remains constant. So that is, it reaches to a saturation point. Hence we call it as an ID becomes equal to IDSS for the further increase in the VDS. Similarly, when we increase the gate source voltage, that is when a gate source voltage is positive, so then drain current increases. So when VGS is equal to 0, we have a drain current till this point. So for increase in a VGS in a positive direction, then it is going to increase the drain current. So further increase again in the gate source voltage, so there will be an increase in the drain current ID. So this is going to happen because number of free electrons are going to get induced, or it is going to get accumulated from p-type substrate to one channel. So similarly, if I'm going, hence from the VGS value 0 volts above, if it goes in a positive direction, we call it as an enhancement mode MOS FET. So if at all gate source voltage is negative, so the number of electrons, free electrons in the N channels are going to get reduced. So therefore ID keeps on decreasing. So this mode we will call it as an depletion mode. And at further some point of time, the VGS, if it is made more negative, the device is going to get off. So this is the drain characteristics curve of DE MOS FET. The N-channel DE MOS FET is in depletion mode when VGS is negative, and it comes to an enhancement mode when VGS is positive. The drain current ID is given by square law expression as ID is equal to IDSS into 1 minus VGS divided by VP whole square. Applications of MOS FETs. So MOS FETs are generally used in digital integrated circuits such as microprocessor. So even it can be used in a calculator. So it can be used in a memories and CMOS logic gates. As an analog switch, it is used in case of an amplifiers. So summary, we have discussed MOS FETs and types of MOS FETs. Also, we have studied construction of N-channel DE MOS FET and working of N-channel DE MOS FET along with its drain characteristics curve. Thank you.